Hello, my dear children. Welcome all of you to your SST class. We are doing the first chapter of history, that is where, when and how. In previous class, we have discussed about the colonial period in India and different sources of modern history, especially the official account. Today, we will conclude this chapter entirely. Let's start the first topic for today's class, and that is the literary sources. Actually, we can say that the literary sources are the written forms of any data which describe the true nature of any society, isn't it? Literary sources again divided into three prominent segments. These are newspapers, journals, letters, second one printed books, and third one photographs and painting. So, large number of nationalist newspapers like the Hindu, Amrita Bazar, Pratika, Kesari were published on that time. Some of these newspapers are printed even today. Letters are also important as they help us to understand a particular situation from a personal point of view. Books tell us about social, economic and political life or conditions of a period. Biographies and autobiographies give an account of the life and ideology of famous personalities. So we can see some of the nationalist writer on that time. They are Rabindranath Tagore, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, Vishnu Shastri, Chiplankar, Bharatendu Harishchandra, okay, and Subramaniam Bharti. They were very popular writer on that time. So, next portion is photographs and paintings. So, picture portray lives of people and events, you know that. So, all the literary sources give us a glimpse of the society, lifestyle, dress and culture of those time, allowing us to understand how Indian society and culture was getting transformed due to the British influence. So, books jo hai ya bolo koi newspaper ya koi photographs ye bahut hi acche se describe karte the on that time jo changes aaye the. Ab wo kiske aane pe? British influence, matlab British ke aane pe jo changes the wo bahut hi acche se describe kiya the sare literary source ne. Okay, our next topic is survey and census. So, in order to effectively administer India, the British government felt the need to map the subcontinent, for which they got various survey conducted. The Office of the Surveyor of India was set up in Dehradun, which prepared detailed maps of different subject and area. So, these surveys and maps give us a detailed information about the flora and fauna, means you know that the wildlife and forest life, okay, crops and soil and topography of India. So, topography means various landforms and relief. Okay, our next topic is oral history. So, oral history is the collection of study of history about information for an individual's families or important events. So, first-hand personal accounts of people who lived in British India and experienced various facts of British rule. Okay, so we know that we also have intense and traumatic accounts of people who went through the dilemma of partition. Such first-hand accounts are also invaluable sources of information. So, jitne sare individual, jitne sare person, jiska khud ka personal experience tha, jo dekhe the partition dekhe the, ya jo British aaye the, uske aane pe jo changes the, wo bahut hi personally experience kiye the. To oral history bhi ek prominent evidence hai modern time ka. Now, my dear children, we are going to talk about the people who made the difference. Under this, we are going to talk about the Bhikaji Kama. Bhikaji Rustam Kama was born in large Parsi family. Right from her childhood, she was a diligent means very caring, disciplined child with a love for language. She actively participated in caring for the plague victims of Bombay in 1896. Having contracted plague herself, she was sent for treatment to England. Actually, she was a dedicated nationalist. She actively took part in the Indian freedom struggle. So, dear children, already we covered this chapter. Just revise all the topics and make a summary. We will meet in our next class with new topics. Till then, bye, take care and happy learning.